pumping. Let's loosen up the joints. Let's generate some heat. Come on, you. There you go. Now, the scenes that you saw from the movie Breakin, you may not get to be that good, but you'll come close. I promise you. And you'll have fun and a great workout. Very good. But before we go on, I have a little test for you. We'll start off by patting the head. Now rub the tummy. Not too bad so far. Lift the leg up. Now twist the leg. Come on, twist that leg. Now jump around in this manner. Now jump back the other way. If you can do that, you can pop and wave and break dance without any trouble. So let's get acquainted with some basic movements. The head first. Four directions. To the left, okay? And one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And to the right. And one, two, three, four. Snap it now. Five, six, seven, eight. Let's move our way down to the neck with something called the stick out. Just stick the neck out and bring it back in, okay? So it's one, two, three, four. Little bit of that giraffe now. Five, six, seven, eight. Loosen it up now. Keep going. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Not bad. Now, let's roll the neck. Come on, roll that neck. Yeah, come on, feel it. If that feels pretty good, let's go in the other direction. Here we go. Roll the neck. Come on, roll it. Okay, and now to the shoulders. Hitch him up. Pop him down. Hitch him up. Pop him down. Hitch and pop. Hitch and pop. Good. Keep hitching those shoulders. Come on now. Now, popping, waving, and breaking, the dances I'm going to teach you today involve all parts of the body. So it is important to come familiar with the body and to warm it up. Come on, keep hitching. Now alternate. One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. Come on. Keep alternating. Fine. Excellent. You can stop now. Let's go to the arms. Arms out. Now pop them. Okay? Popping involves the tightening and snapping out of the joints. So bend slightly and pop. Bend slightly and pop. Come on. One pop, two pop, three pop, four pop. Now you know where popping got its name. Seven pop, eight pop. Great. And now to the chest. Pop it out and back. Pop it out and back. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. You're great. Now the next thing we'll work on is the chest roll. But before we do that, let's see how an expert uses it. This is my friend Shrimp in Breakin. Feet on the ground firmly. Lean forward, stick the chest out. Now move in a counterclockwise direction. As you move backwards, pull the rib cage in,
you know, like the Hulk.
Now lean forward, push the chest around, and contract it. Come on, push it out, circle. Come on, get comfortable with it. Dancers call this the rib cage isolation, so isolate it. Push it out. And roll it in. Come on. In. Out. How's it feel? Very good. Okay, let's get back to some popping. With the hips. Hip pop. Hip pop. Come on, hit those. Hip pop. Hip pop. Snap it. Hip pop. Come on, feel those hip pop. Feel them. Come on. Feel it. Good, good. Let's keep working our way down to the legs. Stretch them. Stretch them out first. Come on. Now let's pop them just like we did with the arms. Bend and pop. Bend and pop. Come on. Bend and pop. Now the other side. Bend and pop. Bend and pop. Both. Come on. Let's make them short and crisp. Come on. All right, now let's see if we can put some of these movements into a combination. An easy one, a confidence builder. Watch. Okay, let's slow it down so you can see what it's all about. Just follow me. The right foot steps to the front, hops twice. That's right. Then steps to the back, pops twice. Not too bad. Now to the side for another two pops. And back together again for two pops. Now let's add some hand movement. The right foot comes forward, pops twice. Extend the hand as though you're shaking hands. And pop the hand and feet together. So there's two pops. Then step to the back. Imagine you're grabbing a baton in a relay race. Then to the side, we're shaking hands again, and back together again. So to the front, shaking hands. In the back, we're grabbing that baton. To the side for another two pops, and back together again. Now let's put the two sides together. That's left and right, okay? So to the right, pops twice. And to the back, I hope we win that relay race. To the side, and back together again. On the left side now. Front for two pops, keep extending the hand. To the back and two pops. To the side and two pops, and back together again. You're gonna do just fine. Now you can see from those scenes that a lot of breaking and popping depends on flexibility or twisting the body, like. Now you've probably noticed that all of these routines use the same move, but in different combinations. Some moves you already know, like the head pop, the arm pop, and the leg pop. But some moves you don't know, like the pivot, the leg swing, the knee roll, and the arm snap. Okay, now let's put them together. For twist of flex number one, I call it the James Brown because it reminds me of some of his old moves. Do it with me now. Feet together. Two, roll the knee. Three, take the right leg and whip it across. Four, interlock the hands. Five, arm snap. Six, head snap. Seven, leg pivot. And eight, we're there. Do it with me now, a bit faster. We have the leg spread apart. We have our knee roll here. We have the right leg whipping across. We have an arm snap, a head snap, a leg pivot, and we're there. You're popping precociously. And on the twist of flex number two, I call it the Bruce Lee. And with me now. One, lift the right leg. Two, pop the left leg twice. Three, step back with the right leg. Four, snap both legs. Five, snap the arms to the right. Six, head snap to the right. Seven, leg pivot. Eight, feet together. And with me now, with some tempo. Lift the right leg up. Two, snap the left leg twice. Three, step back with the right leg. Four, snap both legs. Five, arm snap to the right. Six, head snap to the right. Seven, leg pivot. Eight, feet together. Boy, you guys are great. Let's go on to number three. Now, this is the real reason it's called the twist of flex, because there's a lot of twisting. I call it the rubber band, man. Arms up above the head. Two, bring the arms down the waist level. Three, twist the arms to the left. Four, snap both legs. 5, lift the left leg and pivot around the right. A bit faster with me now. Up, down, twist, snap, turn. We're there. And number 4, just goes in the other direction. Arms up, back down. Twist the body, this time to the right. Snap the legs, lift the right leg and pivot left. You did it. Let's do all 4 twist and flexes together. Here we go. Feet together. Roll the knees. Whip the right leg across. Arms interlock. Arm snap. Head snap. There's your leg pivot. Now step together. Here we go. Bend the back again. Bend your knees. Lift the right leg up. Snap twice off of the left. Step back with the right leg. Pop both legs. There's the arm snap. There's the head snap. There's your leg pivot. Step together. We're bending again. Bend the back. Bend your knees. This time, lift the arms up. This time, bring them down. Twist the arms. Snap the legs. Lift the left leg and pivot over the right. One more bend. Bend the back. Bend your knees. Arms up again. We're going in the opposite direction. Down. Turn them to the right. Snap the legs. Lift the right leg and pivot left. Now to the music. Feel that. Come on. Combinations, don't look at mine. The steps in those scenes are built on what are called slides and the moonwalk. These are very elegant and smooth moves. They make you feel very suave and sophisticated, like the backslide. Made famous by a great entertainer called? Michael Jackson. Hey, I see a few new faces out there. Come on, let's do it together. Stand up straight. Lift the left leg up. Come down on the left toe. Now drag the right foot back and point it. Now slide the left foot back and point it. Now slide, point, slide, point, slide, point, slide, point, slide, point. Now, how are you gonna get back? With the front slide. Do it with me. Stand up straight. Lift the left leg up. Come down on the left toe, drag the right foot back and point it. Now take the right leg and put it slightly in front of the left leg, point it down, and drag the left foot back. Continue the motion. Instead of slide point, you have point slide, point slide, point slide, point slide, point slide. Now let's go forward with it. Up with the left leg, down on the left toe. Drag the right foot back and point it. Now lift the left leg slightly in front and slide. Point slide, point slide, point slide, point slide. Terrific. Now let's go back and forth. Back slide first, front slide second. Here we go. Up on the left leg, down on the left toe. Drag the right foot back and point it. Slide point, slide point, slide point, slide point, slide, point. Now forward, reverse, point, slide. Point, slide, point, slide, point, slide, point, slide. Okay, let's figure out something to do with the arms. Try this as though you're walking. Just use them like you do when you're walking, in rhythm with the feet, right? Now remember, we're still doing the back slide and the front slide, but get the arms in sync. Up on the left leg, down on the left toe, slide it. Now what happens is we're backsliding, so slide point, slide point, slide point, slide point, slide point. Good, now let's front slide, keep the arms working. Point slide, point slide, point slide, point slide, point slide. Now reach back. Remember like we had the baton way long time ago. Let's keep using that. Arms moving in sync. Come on. Good. Terrific. You're ready for my all-time favorite, the moonwalk. This is an action where the right toe goes to the left heel, to the right heel. So you have toe to toe, heel, heel. Now try it with me. Start off, plant the right toe. You're transferring weight to the left toe. To the left heel, to the right heel. So right toe, to the left toe. To the left heel, to the right heel. Toe to toe, heel, heel. Now, for the upper part of the body. Remember that rib cage isolation exercise we did earlier? Well, this is when it pays off. Reminder, plant the feet. Lean forward, stick the chest out. Now move in a counterclockwise direction. As you're leaning back, pull the rib cage in and circle. Like the Hulk, pull it out and roll it. Push it way in, come on. Do it with me now. Circle, come on, circle that torso. Fine, get comfortable. And now, with the feet, ribcage circling on top, feet circling on the bottom. Let's add them. Toe to toe, heel, heel. Roll it, come on. Get comfortable with it. Okay, now if you're having any trouble with the moonwalk, here's something for you to remember. A handy tip from Uncle Odie. Try this. Now you have to imagine yourself the bus driver. This brings the arm up. Turn the key on and get the gas moving there a little bit. Now, in order to get the bus moving, you have to put your foot on the gas. Now, this represents the right toe. Okay, we're driving and all of a sudden something happens. So, you have to put your foot on the brake. And now we look back and our passengers are saying, well, why is the bus driver standing up in the seat? So, we have to roll back in the seat. So, it's the gas, the brake, and you roll back in the seat. The gas, the brake, roll back in the seat. Keep rolling, come on, rib cage, pull it. Now let's combine all the three steps into one sequence. First, the backslide. Up on the left leg, down on the left toe. Slide point, slide point, slide point, slide point. Slide point. It's time for the front slide. Reverse it. Point slide. Point slide. Point slide. Point slide. Point slide. And into the moonwalk. You're driving that bus. Steering wheel up. Gas, brake, and we're rolling in rhythm with the feet. All right. Then turn the corner and wave goodbye to Mom. Bye, Mom. I'm going to Jupiter. See ya.
Thank you.
Those clips of Shabba-Doo and shrimp all involve waving, a great dance movement that gets its name because of its continuous motion, like the waves on the ocean. The simplest waving move is the arm wave, which looks like this. Even though the arm wave looks like one continuous movement, it's really made up of a bunch of smaller moves, and they're all put together. One, knuckles on the finger. Two, the wrist. Three, the elbow. Four, the shoulder. Five is a transfer to the other shoulder. Six, the elbow. Seven, the wrist. And eight, your knuckles. Go with me now. One, the knuckles on the finger. Two, the wrist. Three, the elbow. Four, the shoulder. Five, a transfer to the other shoulder. Six, the elbow. Seven, the wrist. And eight, the knuckles. Now we'll go back with it. From left to right. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Now back, right to left. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Smooth it out. Put some oil in that water. Make it slick. Okay, now let's take the wave into the body. Start with both arms extended, bend the knuckles. Two, there's your wrist. Three, both elbows. Four, both shoulders up, crunch them. Five, now for change, remember those early chest exercises, pop that chest out. Arch your back to the hips, that's area six. Seven, the legs are wide open. Eight, you close. You have to bring them up, so open the knees twice. There's your hips, there's the chest, the shoulders, the elbows, the wrist, and the knuckles. So together now, extend the arms. One, the knuckles on the finger. Two, the wrist. Three, both elbows. Four, both shoulders up. Five, pop that chest out. Six, arch it to the hips. Seven, the legs are open. And eight, you close. We're coming up. Open the knees twice. There's the hips. There's your chest, the shoulders, elbow, wrist, and knuckles. And now, let's combine it all. First, the arm wave to the right, then the arm wave to the left, then down in the body, then bring it up again. Let's give it a shot. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and back. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and down. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and up. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And with me now, a bit faster, count with me. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Keep going. Good. Down. Arch. Hip. Not bad. Good. And now to show you that you just don't have to dance by yourself, here's a clip of Lucinda and Shrimp dancing together.
Now you know their names and the moves they make.
And if a challenge to prove your reputation to stay.
Cause in the break dance battle, they never flake. So come on, everybody, let's rock this break, break, break.
Do that though. Well, come on, come on, Reg. Come on, Paula. Now you turn this way, turn the side, and I want to see one arm go across and bring it back. Come on. Bring it back, Reg. Not throwing hands together. Reg, you go down first. Uh-oh. Come on, that's okay. Yeah. I'll buy that. We One of the best things about popping, waving, and breaking is the freedom it lets you have to do what you want. So, break some rules. Use your imagination. Don't try to be like everyone else. You can even wear costumes. Or you can use a prop, like Shrimp does in this scene from Breakin. If you don't have a broom handy, use everyday situations for your dance, like eating. Ah, I love spaghetti. That's pretty rough spaghetti. After which, you probably want to brush your teeth. Or, if you're a sports nut, go for some extra thrills. Dribbling a basketball down court. 3 seconds left. Otis has the ball. Fakes one man, then another. Oh, my. Boom! You can take a character from history, like the old Egyptian. It's Tet time. And combine it with the Twister Flex. Or with the slide. And you can put your hands here, or there, or here, or down here, or up here, down, up, and then go into the future and come up with E.T. So add your own creativity. There are no restrictions except to have a good time. Oh. Boy, that's really incredible breaking. You may wonder where this kind of dancing comes from. Well, its roots go way back. For example, here you can see the influence of martial arts. In these moves, you can see the kind of stuff Gene Kelly and Donna O'Connor used to do. And in moves like this, you can see formal gymnastics at work. Also, keep in mind that these dancers are all well protected by pads. Back pads, elbow pads, knee pads. They're pros, and they know, don't be a hero. So, wear pads whenever you can. Knee pads. Something for the back, put that on there. This is a pad. Shoes. Make sure they have a lot of support and padding. Otherwise, you'll regret it, okay? All right? Now, almost all of the breaking is groundwork. It takes place on the floor. But how do you get there? The rhythm step, which goes like this. It's real simple. Just do a crossover step. Start with the feet parallel to each other, start bouncing, and then step over with your right leg over the left. Okay, do that again now. Right over left, bring it back. Right over left. Okay, now let's come back to the original place. We're going to the other side. Left leg over the right. Boom, bring it back. Left. Left one more time. Now let's put it together here. In the time of the music, right leg, back place. Left leg, bring it back in place. Right leg, back in place. Left leg, back in place. Ground back, reverse, and repeat. Keep doing that so I can make sure you have that. Okay, four variations. Double each crossover step. One, two, bring it back. Double, double, bring it back. Double, double, bring it back. Double, 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 double. That might work. Double, double.
Tricky.
Double. Double. How's it feel? Double. Double. Come on. Now let's add the arms. Come on, just swing them back and forth to the music. Play with it. Where's that double variation? Or if you want to get fancy with it, here we go. Huh. Ha. La, la, la. Ha. Hoo. But try to keep it simple. The point is to get to the floor. Now, imagine the space in front of you to be the face of a clock. Step into the middle of it. Here is 12 o'clock. Here is 3 o'clock. Here is 6 o'clock. And here is 9 o'clock. Okay, now let's get into the 6 o'clock position in the crazy legs position. Are we there? Yeah? Okay. Now, lift the right hand up, all the way up, and walk to 12. Okay? How'd that go, okay? Lift the left hand up and walk back to 6. Now, let's do it slowly. You're starting off with the right hand up, left foot, right foot, left foot, right foot, both arms down, now the opposite. Right foot, left foot, right foot, left foot. Very good.
Now we're ready to try some moves at 12.
Now, kick the right leg, kick the left leg. Kick the right leg, plant, all the way over, walking over on hands and feet. Now we have to get back, so that's opposite. Kick the left leg, kick the right leg. Kick the left leg, plant all the way over. Now, let's shorten it up. If you don't want to go all the way over, you can vary it. So kick the right leg, the left leg, kick, plant, over. Now bring it back. Now let's go to the other side. Left, right, over. Bring it back, even shorten even more. Kick, plant, over. Other side, kick, plant, over. Or double them up for variation.
kick, plant, over, over. Other side, left, plant, over, over. Now bring it back to six. Now, here's some moves at six. Okay, so we have crisscrossing this way and crisscrossing this way. Also, the bucking bronco. Boom. Wow. Now, while we're grabbing some air, take a look at these shots from Breakin' to see what we're gonna do next. We can do that, you guys. Come on. Cartwheel start at six, right? Are we there? Take the left foot and plant it under to 3 o'clock. Use the right hand and do a simple cartwheel over. Let's go back, though, so you just reverse it. There's your right leg, left hand. Push off and turn. There's only one thing left, and I know you've been waiting for it, spins. And to give you an idea of the different kinds of spins, let's take a look at a selection from Breakin'. Let's start with the basics. The knee spin. Get to the center of the clock from six, right? So six is back here. Here's your knee. Now, merely lift up the left leg. Lift it all the way up. How are we doing? Okay? Now, bring the hands slightly out in front of you and begin walking around on them. Walk around, first slow. Then if it gets comfortable, speed it up. Make sure you're still wearing your pads. Okay, here's a move that you can do in only a few minutes. All you have to do is grab your hands like this and put them on the feet. This is called a one-man wheel. You merely shift the weight rolling over and lift yourself in the air. While you're in the air, the feet are open. Then you come down, the feet are together. Shift the weight over, legs up. Shift the weight over and down. Now speed it up. Roll, open it up, roll it. Come on, wheel. Sit spin. Sit down with the left leg straight out in front of you and the right leg bent, as though you were in a split, okay? Now, what happens is you're going to kick with the right leg with force as hard as you can, open up the legs and spin around in this manner. What we're looking for early is just the open position with the hands underneath the knees, okay? Let's try it the first time. Let's try it again. Left leg out, right leg is bent. Open up the legs and close. Now that you've learned the technique for the sit spin, you're ready for the major back spin. Your first position is open. Leg out, right leg bent. Second position, down and kick. See how we are? Now, here we go. The momentum with the left arm lifted us. That's three and four, our big close. Now, let's try it a little bit faster. Open, kick, open, close. Even faster now. Open, kick, open, close. Even faster now. Open, kick, open, close. You're a champ. The last thing I'm going to show you is a special treat. It's called the egg roll. It's similar to the backspin, but instead of open, kick, open, close, and you're in tight, you're going to kick the leg in a circular motion all the way across. Looks a little bit like this. Up on the shoulders. Okay, but be sure you're wearing pads when we do this. So the left leg is out. The right leg is bent. You kick past and go up to the shoulder, see where I am, and land on those feet. Do it again. Right leg bent. Left leg straight out. Kick the right leg and go up on the shoulders and come down on the feet. One more time. Up and over. Up. Bend over, up, bend over. With all of these spins, there's a question of stopping, and stopping with style. And that's where poses come in. I'll show you what I mean. And now, let's see what you've learned. Come on, form a circle, join hands. Let's see an arm wave started for me, Barry. Interlock hands, go. All the way around, let's go, 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 go. Barry, I need you.